What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and in this video, I want to talk about a problem that I see with a lot of the resources out there that people use for coding interview prep. And specifically, I see this problem a lot when I coach people on system design interviews. Because system design is something that's really hard, right? System design is something that I think a lot of times it's using the skills that we have available to us, using the skills that we've already learned, but are not necessarily things that we've ever thought about applying in this sort of interview setting, in this sort of situation where we actually have to say, okay, I'm going to develop this system, but I'm going to explain all the thought processes behind it. I'm going to explain exactly why I'm choosing to do this and why I'm not choosing to do that and why this is technically correct. Right? This is something that a lot of times when we are actually working in our job, we do things based on precedent. We do things because these are the technologies, these are the tools that are already being used at our company. And yes, maybe someone thought about, well, what is the advantage to this as opposed to that? But you are not necessarily thinking about that when you're designing a system, because you're never designing something completely from scratch. And then also, you have lots of other people who are working with you on the process. So for example, you have like DevOps who are telling you, oh, we need this many clusters for, you know, our database, and all this stuff that we don't think about in system design when we are actually doing it in the real world. And then in the interview, we're in this totally different situation. And this is kind of what I want to describe here, because this is what I see, is that people conflate reality and they conflate what they see in videos teaching them how to do this with what the interview should actually look like. And so let me explain what I mean by this. There are a lot of videos out there. I'm gonna just use system design as an example here, but this applies to technical interviewing as well. There are examples, like if you go on YouTube and search for just Netflix system design, then there are a ton of videos that will take you through, like, here is how Netflix systems are designed. Right, here are all the things that went into these systems. Here are some of the specific characteristics of those systems. These are the reasons why they decided to do this as opposed to that. And while that's really educational, and while there is a lot that you can learn from watching those videos, that is not what a system design interview is. Right? That is not what a system design interview is going to look like, because what that really is it's saying, let me explain to you how this existing system works. Let me explain to you what these engineers came up with over the course of the last 10 years as they were trying to design a perfectly optimal system to handle all of these different cases, as they were trying to deal with all of the business implications and all of the constraints around building a massive streaming platform that can support millions and millions and millions of users. Now, that's very different from saying, okay, you have 45 minutes. We want to design something. Let's design it. We want to design something that has these certain constraints, let's design it. And so while you can learn specific pieces of the puzzle, while you can learn what people have done creatively to be effective and to make platforms like Netflix work as well as they do, that is not what your system design interview is going to look like. And so I think a lot of times we watch these videos that are teaching us how to do something, and we assume that that is how we should be performing in our interview. Now, to give another example, let's consider a technical problem. Let's consider, you know, for example, the 0-1 knapsack problem. Now, if you know how to solve that problem, there are some fixed set of problems, and that's a pretty popular one, so it's very possible that you may have solved it before. But when you watch the video, the person's not gonna sit there and wonder about it for 15 minutes. They're not gonna sort of contemplate, oh, well, is this what I'm supposed to do? Maybe I could do it this way, maybe I could do it that way. At most, what they're gonna do is they'll share with you, here are a couple of the trade-offs, here are a couple of the different ways that we can do it, now this is the way that I'm gonna do it, and then they're going to go through and they're gonna write perfect code, right? This is just how it works, because it wouldn't be a great video if you spent an hour working through the problem. You can certainly find videos like that out there, but they are very much in the minority. And so it sets this false expectation, because we look at those videos and we think, this is what I'm expected to do in my actual interview. This is the way that they expect me to perform in my interview. Whereas this video's goal is to teach you how to solve the problem. So, like, for example, I think I have a video on the 0-1 knapsack problem that is about 20 minutes long on my YouTube channel. And it takes me about 20 minutes to explain it. If I were going to solve this problem in an interview, it probably would not take me 20 minutes. In that video, like, to be totally transparent, I wrote the whole thing out and I have the code next to me as I'm teaching it, because that makes it easier for me to teach. And so I think it is important, and I think it is valuable to learn how do I do this problem. But you have to realize that there's a difference between seeing someone teaching the thing and how it's going to be in your interview. And again, to come back to the system design stuff, I think I see this all the time, because people think, oh, I have to design this super complicated system. And no, I never would have thought of using this API gateway here and the load balancer here and all these different components, where yes, you'll come up with some of that in your interview. Like, yes, you should be thinking about these things, but are you going to design this incredibly complicated system in 45 minutes? No, absolutely not. You just don't have the time for that. And so when you're watching these videos, when you're watching anything, when you're studying your interview prep, take everything with a grain of salt. Realize that what you are being shown is not the same as what you are going to do in your interview. That's why I think it's great if you can do, for example, on interviewing.io, they have a handful of recordings of actual mock interviews that they did. They have a handful on their YouTube channel that people did on the platform. That is much, much better in terms of understanding what that interview process is going to look like than watching someone walk through the problem. It's not necessarily as educational. Like, you're not going to learn as much from it because it's less information dense, since it is spread out over that time, but it's going to teach you that. And this is something that we've been adding to our course 6 weeks interview ready as well. I've been conducting a bunch of mock interviews and doing some mock interviews myself and recording all of those so that you have that resource so that you can see like what this process actually looks like. Because you don't want to go into the interview and say like, oh, well, I'm not immediately coming up with the ideal solution and therefore I'm like going to fail it because I didn't come up with a solution like that. And I see that all the time. Like, people get stressed out that, oh, well, I wasn't able to come up with the solution immediately and therefore I'm not going to be successful. So they get in this like death spiral of, you know, second guessing themselves, thinking they're not doing well enough, and then that leading them to do worse. And so my whole point here, everything that you watch, it can be a learning educational thing, but take it with a grain of salt. Understand that what you are watching is not the same as what your interview process is going to look like. This is a person who has taken the entire solution, and you work backwards to think about how do I teach this in the most effective way. In your interview, you're working forwards. You're using like a bottom-up approach versus when you're teaching, generally you use a top-down approach where you start with the final solution and you work backwards from there. In your interview, you're working forwards, and so you don't know the exact path that you're following. You know the end goal, but you don't exactly know the path that it's going to take you to get there. Whereas if you already have the end goal, if you already know the code, it's easy to work backwards and say, okay, what's the best path for me to take? So with that, that's all I got for you today. Do watch these videos, do learn, do get educated about how to solve these problems, but make sure that you are understanding why you are watching the material, understanding why you are consuming this and what the value of this is versus the value of everything else out there. And with that, that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this, definitely do take a look at our 50 coding interview questions guide. This is an example. I give you a lot of video walkthroughs. They're not the same as what you're going to do in the interview, but you will learn how to solve the problem. So definitely check that out. Appreciate you joining me here, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.